to reside there. In it a stove that still bears the traces of fire. A little spinning top and a tin man, a top coat, a trunk with a strip of blue calico mending a gentlemen, I am the kind you want for your companion. A civic-minded man, the kind you want in your businessman, the kind you want for your partner, doctor, pharmacist, land development. Refinery, hotelier, humanus, intelligentius, arachnoidus. My business, profit, my commending a seam, a woman's shoe, an ink bottle, a handful of pearl dress. September of my 20th year. I studied medicine in Ann Arbor, hundreds of miles from friends and relatives, wife and child in New York. $20 in my pocket, 9 months of work ahead. I need money. A plan, intelligentius. It is well known that in the state of Michigan, if one studies medicine, all the materials needed for dissection are supplied by the state. The state needs materials. Manus, for which they pay handsomely. Argentus, I supply the materials with the help of my classmate. Business. We graduate and find that doctoring is not profitus. We devise a plan for doing business. Of a little waltz. A trusted friend of modest means, already insured for life, increases his policy to protect his child and wife. Should harm befall him, later on, the trusted friend already begins to drink quite heavily and kills his wife and kills his child and blames it on insanity. In reality, they all go west and wait for each other. Some months later, a body is discovered, badly decomposed. With the body is a letter, a suicide note. A relative collects the money, we split it into three. The relative, the trusted friend, my classmate, and me. We need three bodies. Rigor mortis, hidden in three cities. Hide us, seek us. Complicated. I kill my classmate instead. I use his insurance to bide my time. Well known that business done with men is straight on, clean, and quickly settled. item. Dr. Russell, a tenant in my hotel, rent due. I struck him on the head with a heavy chair. I sold his body, $45. Item. Mr. Rogers, an acquaintance from Virginia. I took him fishing and struck him on the head with the oar. Just practice. Item. Charles Cole, a southern speculator, a vicious blow, crushed his head so badly that he was almost useless to the party that bought him. $2,000. Robert Latimer, my janitor, discovering my business, he wanted money. I locked him in the vault of my hotel and slowly starved him. Item. Benjamin Peitzel, my business partner, and his son. After 7 years of practice, I carried out my plan. Originalus, insurance fraudus. Item. Wade Warner, I bought my glass bending furnace from him. I paid a fortune for it. A fortune! Asking him to demonstrate the furnace, I left him in it. Incineris corpus invisibilis. Fortune returnus, business expandus. Confidence of women, you learn to juggle trust. First you set thus a hotel, then you set the method. Secret fancy to her. I called her acquaintance of a race. I invited her to step into my vault to retrieve a cup and tray. I close and lock the door. She cried. She begged me to let her out. Denied. Unless she wrote a letter, leaving Quinlan for good. If she wrote the letter, then release her, I would. She did. I killed her. Thirteen ladies, there may have been more. 13 ladies, I cannot say for sure. Any and Annie Williams of wealthy estate required my protection, which I freely gave. Many came to live with me of her own volition. My visits to Nanny ignited her suspicion. Minnie Mern and Nanny, ah, I disposed of Minnie, ah, being their protector, ah, I was their estate's executor. Ah, been more. 13 ladies, I cannot say for sure. Sarah Cook, her unborn child, and Mary Harrah, a 3-for-1 they became. Julie Cannon, her daughter Pearl, came to me and never went away. Nellie and Annie Peitzel suffocated in a trunk. Anna Betts, Gertrude Connor, poisoned just for fun. My mistress, she broke my heart. I locked her in my vault and watched her slowly starve. Ah, 13 ladies. Three waitresses in my restaurant, I thought I would connive to chloroform all three at once, of course, to watch them die. They escaped. They went to the authorities. Suspicions were raised. The end of my story. up, and a tin man, a top coat, a trunk with a strip of blue calico mending a seam. A woman's shoe, an ink bottle, handful of pearl dress buttons, a strand of hair caught on a stovepipe, a jawbone, 17 teeth. It's time.